Welcome to Shriner's Gardens. I'm Ben Shriner. I'm going to show you today three of the most common pests and diseases of bearded irises. The first one we're going to show you is leaf spot. You can see leaf spot on this leaf right here. It's these brown spores. It's caused by excess moisture. So the way you treat leaf spot is you just clip off the leaves here. You can see that there's leaf spot here. Down below, the fan is fine, so you just clip that off. You can also treat iris with a general fungicide in the spring. So, like I said, it's caused by excess moisture, so it's an issue we deal with here in Oregon. As the summer continues and it continues to warm up and dry out, leaf spot usually abates on its own. The next big issue is slug damage. You can see slug damage on these fans here. The best way to treat slug damage is to put slug bait out or traps. You want to get on that early in the spring, but again, as the garden kind of fills out with vegetation, usually slugs move away from iris and go to other plants to feed on. The third issue we're going to show you today is soft rot. You can see here, this is evidence of soft rot. The fans have browned and collapsed, and if you kind of poke around at the rhizome, you'll see it's kind of soft and mushy. That's evidence of soft rot. It's caused by bacteria in the soil. Usually when the soil is too rich, so if you plant in fresh compost or manure, you're going to increase your chances of soft rot. If it's really wet, sometimes you'll get soft rot. The way you treat soft rot is you just have to dig out the infected rhizomes, discard them. If you have a big infection that's spreading to other rhizomes, other clumps, you're going to want to dig out the soil. So go about 6 inches down and replace the soil with an aged compost, for example. So those are three of the most common pests and diseases of bearded irises.